with KHON2 Sports, Rob DeMello.
How's it going, everybody? Regular season interleague matchups don't get much bigger than this. Tonight on the North Shore, a rematch of the 2011 state title game with defending champion Kahuku of the OIA playing host to reigning ILH winner Punahou will pick things up in the first quarter. No score until Buff and Blue quarterback Tui Tuileta hooked up with sophomore receiver Kanavai Noah for number 9's fourth touchdown in the first five quarters of 2012. Buffs led 13-0 at the break, but in the second half, Red Raiders running back Alfunga Wiley broke out, posting touchdown runs of 48, 28, and 22 yards in the final 24 minutes, posting 178 of his 223 yards in the second half alone, making Punahou's first ever drive back from the North Shore a long one. 21-13 Kahuku the final, as the Red Raiders remain unbeaten against Oahu schools at home since 2007. Over in Wahiawa, another big-time Division I Interleague matchup took place under the Saturday night lights, where public school power Lelehua beat private school juggernaut Kamehameha. Warriors led 10-0 in the second quarter, but the Mules' defense pitched a shutout the rest of the way, punctuated by Keanu Kamakaivi's forced fumble in the end zone, recovered by Malik Morton. Mules get payback for the 2004 state title game loss to Double Blue. 12-10 the final, green and gold, now 2-0 in 2012. Over in Waipahu, a rematch of last season's Division II state title game took place as the Marauders hosted five-time defending D2 champ Iulani, and this game was all blue and gold for most of the night, with running back Matapua Tulafale's three-yard plunge and ensuing two-point conversion, giving Waipahu a 34-21 lead in the fourth quarter. But check this, Raiders scored 14 unanswered in 136 seconds. Iulani remains unbeaten, 35-34 the final. Marauders stunned at 0-2. Across the street from the Windward YMCA, OIA White Division battle at Kailua High School, where Kalaheo snagged its first victory of 2012, beating Kaiser. In the win for the Mustangs, Christian Johnston with a 20-yard touchdown run, 21-20 Stangs the final. For scores from games played across the state tonight, check out our website, KHON2.com. Now elsewhere on the gridiron, the University of Hawaii football team wrapped up its training camp today at the Joint Base Pearl Harbor Hickam, as Norm Chow and company held 9 practices over a 7-day period. They'll get the day off tomorrow before returning to school on Monday. Now in exactly 14 days, UH will open their 2012 season on the road in Los Angeles and will be against the number 1 ranked team in the country, as USC came in at top spot of the Associated Press preseason poll released today. Kickoff between Hawaii and SC set for September 1st, 1:30 Hawaii time, and that game will be televised right here on KHON2. Now week 2 of the National Football League's preseason continued today, where a scary moment took place in Chicago as Kamehameha graduate and Bears third round draft choice safety Brandon Harden suffered a neck injury in the third quarter of Chicago's 33-31 win over Washington. He was taken from the field on a stretcher and is spending the night at a local hospital for tests. According to the team, initial indications are positive. We'll keep you posted as more information regarding his condition is provided. Now back here at home, Hilo native and future UFC Hall of Famer BJ Penn revealed today that his rescheduled return from retirement against Rory McDonald will take place December 8th, a part of the UFC on Fox 5 card, televised locally right here on KHON2. Now the prodigy confirmed the much anticipated matchup today at the grand opening of the UFC BJ Penn gym at Kaka'ako, saying he's been told the bout will likely take place in San Jose. Now the welterweight showdown was initially slated for September 22nd in Toronto, but McDonald pulled out of the fight after suffering a cut in training. Now with the date locked down, emotions seemed to be getting the best of the Canadian tri-star gym fighter, as the teammate of George St. Pierre was quoted as saying that he will probably end up killing BJ Penn in the octagon. Today the 33-year-old two-time UFC champ said he will not get caught up in the war of words.
Hey, you know what? Last time when I fought TriStar Gym, I had the negative energy on me saying I was going to kill them. So maybe they're just putting it on themselves now. So it's just all good. It's all good. Let them talk. Let them go. Mentally, I'm great. I've actually pretty much just been through a whole training camp. So I've really shed a lot of body fat and stuff. And now, since the fight got pushed back, I'm just going to just keep going. I'm not going to stop. I'm going to make sure not to overdo it, but I'm not going to stop.
Now again, Penn celebrated the grand opening of the UFC gym today. For much more info about the facility and an extended interview with Penn, check out our website, KHON2.com. And finally, over on the links, Punahou graduate Michelle Wee put herself in major contention for her first top 30 finish of 2012. Stanford alum carded a second round 2-under-70, moving to -5 for the week in a tie for 11th place. Two-time LPGA winner has made just 7 of 14 cuts this season, placing 45th in the latest world rankings. Now, Mika Miyazato, holds top spot at 11-under-par. As for Punahou grad Stephanie Kono and Sacred Hearts alum Ayaka Kaneko, both missed the cut. Third and final round is set for tomorrow.
Check out her fashion, huh?
Yeah, I like the hair.